Can you talk about the impact of Macau and Singapore for LVS this morning? It seems like with economic data bottoming in Asia, that potentially could be a huge driver for LVS through 2019.
Yeah, no, I think that's a good point. And I thought the quarter was solid. I mean, they did play a little lucky, but even ex that, the quarter was solid. And this is all happening, and LVS had a string of decent quarters, but this is all happening with a really tough China macro backdrop, right? So we know that we segment the business. You have VIP, and then you have the mass, and the VIP tends to, well, does have a lot lower margin because you're going through a junket middleman. That's the business that's been under pressure. Mass business has been growing double-digit for the market, even against tough comps, which is a great mix shift for the business. But then you have to ask yourself, we were at double-digit comps in a tough macro environment. What happens if the economy picks up? Certainly VIP will do better, but mass could actually pick up as well. So I'm pretty bullish on Macau. LVS, I think, is going to have some choppy quarters because of construction disruption out there. But generally speaking, the trend should be higher for all these businesses.
I guess if there's disruption because of construction, that's probably a buying opportunity.
Definitely a buying opportunity. I always look at it this way. If a company blames construction disruption, you got to go out there yourself and look at it. So I try to do that. We did it with Red Rock in the Palms when they were undergoing construction disruption.
You have a terrible job going to visit casinos.
Well,
How do I get your job?
Yeah, it could be worse. Going to Miami, cruise lines,
Yeah.
it's not too bad. I think I picked the right sectors.